Everyone knows there are differences between services and products, but not everyone knows what the differences are. In this lecture, we will look at service operations. Services are hugely important. Most industrialized countries are now service economies, where the majority of people work in the so-called tertiary sector. It is not unusual that services accounts for more than 80% of a country's gross domestic product. Note that services are widely different. Being a teacher is not the same as being a pilot, a banker, gardener, chef, consultant, or a prison guard. Although all these jobs sort as services. These jobs are clearly different, but each of them can be broken down to processes and analyzed with the similar improvement methods we use in production management. Traditionally, four key characteristics make services different from products. First, intangibility. You cannot hold or touch a service, but you can experience it. While manufacturers produce an output, service companies produce an outcome. Second, inseparability. Services tend to require simultaneity of production and consumption. For example, it is quite difficult to cut your hair with the hairdresser without being there. Hence, in services, the customer is present in the conversion process. Third, heterogeneity. It is very difficult to make each service experience identical. If you take your friends to a restaurant or a soccer match, your service experience will differ, even though you eat the same food or watch the same game. And fourth, perishability. Services are time restricted and you cannot store a service. In services, the product is equal to the process. This means that the chances to correct quality problems before delivery are rare. It also has important implications for capacity management and explains why frontline employees can make it or break it for a service company. However, in reality, there is no sharp demarcation between manufacturing and services. And those boundaries that used to be there are more and more blurred by the development of IT. Instead of products versus services, it may be more fruitful to talk about service intensiveness versus manufacturing intensiveness. In practice, there's always a mix of products and services. Hence, we can introduce the product-service continuum. The purest products are arguably commodity raw materials, and among the purest services, we find education. In between, in all kinds of different industries, there's a mix of products and services. Even if you buy your own car, there's a range of related services that you need, such as the sales process, insurance, and repair. Or consider a restaurant, which traditionally is considered a service, but clearly involves the production or assembly of food products. Even the entertainment industry, such as cinema, involves the production of a film. But back to the more general definition of services. Let's first differentiate archetypes of services. We can split between six types. Business-to-business services include catering, maintenance, consultancy, and so on. Business-to-consumer services include, for example, restaurants, hairdressers, wellness, bars, and festivals. Internal service, which are service departments within firms such as finance, HR, internal audit. Then we have public services, such as those provided by the government, police and prisons, public schools and higher education, and even hospitals. Then not-for-profit organizations such as charities, student organizations, and religious organizations. And finally, we have consumer-to-consumer services, which cover all types of services we conduct between friends and family. Now, let's look at a few useful concepts that help us analyze service processes. In manufacturing, CPOC looks like this. But in services, CPOC looks like this. Think about it. If you're sick and visit your doctor, you are the most important input to the process. You're even your own supplier. There are also other inputs, of course, like the doctor and medical equipment. Then, during your visit, you are part of the process, for example, taking a blood sample or answering the doctor's question. And what about the output? Correct, that's you too, and hopefully with a good diagnosis. In many services, the customer is an integrated part of the process. We can therefore say that these services are co-produced by the customer. In other services, the customer is more of a passive receiver. An example here can be cleaning services in a hotel. One useful concept is the differentiation between back office and front office service operations. There's a line of visibility which separates the parts of the process that require customer presence and those that do not. Note that we are more flexible in organizing things as we please in the back office. Often these processes can be more standardized and streamlined. The front office operations are essential for the customer service experience and must therefore be carefully planned and maintained. I am sure you have experienced both exceptionally good and terribly bad front office operations. When we analyze service processes, we can always ask if we can move activities from or to the front office and what effects that would have on the costs and service outcomes. Let's take this lecture as an example. The service process happens right now as you watch the video. Your experience depends on a range of factors: the quality of the sound and picture, the complexity of the content, my performance, your mood, your familiarity with the topic, where you see it, what else you have on your mind, and so on and so on and so on. Even if I'm not there with you physically, this is front office, where you interact with technology. There were of course also a lot of back office processes taking place before the video was produced, including writing a script, planning and recording the video. When we meet for questions and answers, it will be front office again. And when I start preparing exam questions based on this material, it will be back office. I can only hope that the outcome of this lecture is that you learn something about service processes that you didn't know before. To recap, we first presented how services differ from products and introduced the product-service continuum. We then separated different types of services before we discussed how the customer is often an integrated part of inputs, the process, and even the output in service processes. And finally, we introduced the useful concept of front office versus back office processes. Okay. Excuse me, may I order a coffee, please?
Of course. Here's your coffee. Enjoy.
Thank you. See ya.